What's up, everyone? Mitesh here with MTech, and today we're going to be talking about the Pixel 2. I know, big surprise for my channel, but we're mainly going to be talking about the Pixel 2 and whether it's slowing down or not. So, if you guys haven't watched it, MKBHD recently made a video about why he doesn't use the Pixel anymore. And I'll link it up here if you guys haven't watched it yet, but the main gist of it was the Pixel 2 for him has gotten slower than most other phones at this point in their life cycle. So the Pixel 2 XL, which is what he normally carries, has gotten too slow for him to keep using it. Instead, he switched over to the OnePlus 6, which has a better processor and more RAM. And that was one of the biggest concerns he has, was the fact that because the Pixel 2 only has 4GB of RAM, it kept putting apps out of memory. So through a long day, when he had to reload apps, it just felt like it was way too slow. So I thought this would be a good opportunity to talk about my experience with the Pixel 2 line and whether after 9 months it's still held up or not, whether mine's slowing down, and basically just give you guys an update about the Pixel 2. Alright, so let's start off by talking about that number one most important thing, which is speed. Is the Pixel 2 still fast? So for me personally, I don't test a lot of flagship level devices like my MKBHD or some of the bigger YouTubers do, so I don't have comparison between this and the OnePlus 6, the Galaxy S9 Plus. I mean, they all have newer processors, so I assume they're a little bit faster, but the Pixel 2 for my personal day-to-day has been just great. It does not slow down. Every time I pick up the phone, it's ready to go. It's never had, like, I wake up the phone after a long while and it just takes a little bit of time to get ready. Instead, it's just ready to go. Now, if you pick it up after like a couple hours, you will have probably a bunch of notifications coming in, so it might be slow for the first like 30 seconds or so, but typically it is good and ready to go. Now, along with the speed, let's talk a little bit about the RAM, because that is the one thing that MKBHD really stressed on, was the fact that you don't know if 4GB of RAM is going to be good for you for 2 or 3 years. I mean, most of reviewers will tell you, like, 6GB of RAM, like, it's nice to have, but it's not really going to make a difference in day-to-day. Whereas MKBHD found that after a couple months, it did start making a difference in day-to-day, but I still think that for most people, it will not, because most people don't use that many apps. Most people are just on social media, web browsing, and text messaging and things like that. They are not using apps constantly throughout the day. So I think for majority of the people, 4GB of RAM is plenty for a phone. Now, once again, if you want to future-proof your phone, if you're going to use your phone for 3 or 4 years, yeah, maybe you should go ahead and buy the one that's giving you 8GB of RAM, because you know what? In 4 years, you may have changed what you're doing with your phone. So definitely, if you can get more, it's great, but if you're stuck with a phone that just has 4GB of RAM, I think it's fine. Alright, so moving on, let's talk about some of the other features since this is basically a 9-month update of my Pixel 2 review. And let's start off with the camera, because that is the biggest selling point for this phone, and yes, the camera is still really good. Even when you compare it to the flagship phones that are coming out right now, compared to the Galaxy S9, S9 Plus, the LG G7, the iPhone X, the OnePlus 6, whatever. This camera is still amazing. Even though it is just a single lens, it's still an amazing camera, and portrait mode on it is still fantastic. Another really nice thing about this device is, of course, the fact that you get updates straight from Google. So right now I'm on the Android P beta, whatever the latest version of the beta is, and once it's officially cut off, I will give you guys a full review of Android P, but for right now I will say that it's been super stable for me and it's worked really well. I will say that I have not felt the slowdowns that other people have felt with their phones. Everything's worked well, notifications are working well, everything for me has worked well, even on the beta, so I have nothing to complain about in terms of software. And the fact that you get 3 years of support for this is great. So I will get Android P. If I were to stick with this phone, I will also get, what comes after P? N-O-P, Q, Q, whatever Q ends up being, R, whatever that ends up being. This phone will get those updates. So you know what? For those of you who are worried about updates, especially on Android 10, it's hard to get guarantees out of anybody that your phone's gonna get updates. So the fact that Google is still offering that is great. And there's really not much else to say about the Pixel 2 phone, because you know what? It is a solid phone. There's nothing special about it though. It's a solid, solid phone with a great camera, but there's really nothing special about it. So if you're looking for a reliable phone with a great camera, the Pixel 2 I think is still a great option. I know Pixel 3 is going to be coming out very soon, but the Pixel 2 I still think if you can get a good deal on it, it's a great option. But if you're someone who wants to be on the bleeding edge, if you're someone who wants to have the latest and greatest specs, yeah, you're going to want to consider something like the OnePlus 6, which has like great specs and a great price. Or the Galaxy S9 Plus if you want something with dual cameras in it, or even the iPhone 10 if you want something that you know you can rely on for a while, slash is iOS. But at this point, I still think the Pixel 2 is worth getting. Not at full price, but if you can get a good deal on it, I still think it's worth buying. But with that, that's pretty much all I have for you guys in this one. If you guys like this one, go and hit that like button. Subscribe if you guys want to see more videos like this. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Bye!